Ladies and gentlemen, we continue with the action here at Cotai Arena. Once again, proudly being brought to you by Bob Arum's Top Rank Incorporated. This bout in association with Ala Boxing Promotions. Tecate con Carácter, Anta, Foreman Boys Promotions, and our host, the Venetian Macau. This bout set for a limit of 10 rounds for the WBO Asia Pacific Super Bantamweight Championship. Damas caballeros, este duelo pactado a un límite de 10 vueltas por el título peso Super Gallo Asia Pacífico de la OMB. Supervisor, supervisor, Leon Panoncillo. The judges are, los jueces son, Sawa Eng Tawikun, Salvin Lagumbay, and Takeshi Shimakawa. The referee, Danrex Tapdasan. Introducing the blue corner. He steps in wearing black with pink trim, presentando la esquina azul, vestido de negro con vivos color rosa. Detuvo la báscula a un peso oficial de 122 libras. He tipped the scales at an official 122 pounds. As a professional, he maintains a record consisting of 23 victories against 5 losses, 1 draw, and 8 of those victories coming by way of knockout. A nivel profesional, mantiene un récord de 23 victorias con 5 derrotas, 1 empate y 8 de sus victorias por la vía del cloroformo. Fighting out of Tokyo, Japan, Konosuke Tomiyama. In the red corner, en la esquina roja, vestido de color blanco con vivos negros, he steps in wearing white with black trim. His official weight, 121.6 pounds, su peso oficial, 121.6 libras. A nivel profesional, se mantiene invicto con 21 victorias, 8 de sus victorias por la vía del knockout. He steps in undefeated in 21 professional bouts. 8 of those victories coming by way of knockout. El actual campeón peso super gallo Asia Pacífico de la OMB. He is the defending WBO Asia Pacific Super Bantamweight Champion. From Bacolod City, the Philippines, Genesis Cervania.
Genesis, come on.
Okay. Give me a good, clean fight. 10 rounds WBO Asia Pacific Championship. Protect yourself at all times. Touch gloves. Good luck. Sawing. Ready? Box.
Welcome back to Macau. Second of our bouts on TopRank.com. We're seeing it live around the world, and this is one we've been looking forward to. Super Bantamweight battle. Genesis Cervania is the defending WBO Asia Pacific Super Bantamweight champion against Konosuke Tomiyama, a long-rangey fighter out of Tokyo, Japan, and he is down quickly. A sudden and dramatic turn that this fight takes immediately. Taking the mandatory 8 count. Just about to tell you that Tomiyama has actually fought for the world championship a couple of years back against Noboru Nishiya and had him down in the first round, but it is he who goes down in the first round of this bout. Cervania, very quick start. Cervania's nicknamed Bazooka comes into the ring with a record of 20-0. Only 7 KOs. Not a big KO mark, but as you can see, he is not devoid of power, and he lands a good left hook there. And a very rocky start for Tomiyama. Cervania looking great here in the opening moments, and now Tomiyama comes back with his first combination of the fight. And here comes Cervania, and these two are throwing the leather early.
Right there.
Yeah, he's trying to get himself into the fight now. A little bit different after that very rocky first minute. And he scores a knockdown with a left hand. Both fighters have tasted the canvas here in round one. Mandatory eight count for the champion, Zerbania. Here comes Tomoyama back. And now we are getting the fight we expected. Good jab by Tomoyama. Onosuke with a very good comeback. Tries that uppercut, and now here comes Zerbania. Chases him to the ropes and back out to ring center. Zerbania trying to regain the momentum that he had built up in the first minute. Very aggressive, as you can see, he's up on his toes. That's his style. And a fine left-right combination by Tomoyama. Stops Zerbania on his track. Zerbania tries to answer back, and the champion is down again. Second time he is down. Three knockdowns in round one. And you just saw a red-hot first round.
Love it, Rich.
Rich Marotta ringside in the Kotai Arena as you look at Tomoyama, joined by Christina Poncher at the ringside. And I'll tell you, Christina, the fans enjoyed that first round.
Absolutely. They...
We'll take a look at what happened in the first round. Zerbania came out and landed that beautiful left hook, thrown perfectly. That sent Tomoyama down for the count of eight. It was a solid knockdown. You're looking at Zerbania, who was in total control at that point. And ended up going down twice himself. As we get ready to start round two, as we will bring Christina Poncher into our equation here, as Tomoyama starts out fast. These fans are into it, Christina. You know, sometimes in Asia, some of the crowds get rather quiet, and they sit back and they watch, and they were into that first round. No knockdown.
They definitely were. That was one of the things I noticed last time when we had a Filipino fighter or a Thai fighter. They were very much into the fight. And this fight here, right here, pitting a Japanese against a Filipino, they're very much interested in this fight. And I think as the night grows and you see more action, we'll hear this crowd really make some noise.
Both of these fighters with a lot of movement. And my study of Zerbania, it seemed to me that he kind of wastes a lot of motion with his arms and his constant up on his toes, jumping up and down. But so far he's come through it. You know, you can't complain about a 20-0 record.
No punch, ready.
But he does utilize a lot of energy, and he certainly got caught with that second knockdown. The first was a flash knockdown. He was actually knocked down by a jab, but the second knockdown was solid.
I did not see that coming after how the fight started.
No, it certainly didn't. It was an amazing turnaround. It happened so fast, in fact, in the first round. I was just about to tell you about the Nobuo Noshiro fight for Tomoyama when he fought for the WBA championship in 09. He was stopped in eight rounds, but he had the champion in a bad way in the first round and knocked down. And this fight is full of action in round one. And now into round two.
Step back.
Wild with that overhand right.
Box.
Some blood there on Genesis Zerbania. It looks like a little bit on his right eyebrow.
I will keep an eye on that. As he comes forward, good aggression, missing that left hand, however. He saw that he's setting down nicely on his punches. Zerbania's knockout record, I started to mention to you, is a bit misleading. He has more power, I think, than what you would think with a guy with 7 KOs of 20 fights. It's perhaps only recently that he's really learning how to punch.
Go there.
Go there.
Told me I was going to be sent to a neutral corner. We're going to take a look at the cut. There you see it spurting out the right eye. Doctor says no problem, carry on, and so they do. Tomiyama, long-rangey fighter, goes right back to that jab. Got those long arms. Pushes it out to set up his straight right hand.
10 seconds, top of the bell, 10 seconds.
As you might have seen in his walk into the arena and his entrance into the ring, he likes to play to the crowd. He's an entertainer. He walks back to his corner.
Even got the tassels on the shoes there.
Mina, Mina. Even the bandy, ka? Ayo paghangan.
Round three scheduled for 10. This is a WBO Asia Pacific Super Bantamweight Championship fight. Genesis Cervania. You see screen right, black trunks with a white stripe. Against Komosuke Tomiyama, Tokyo, Japan. He is in the black with the pink trim. We've seen a real good fight, very competitive here. Tough to pick who the winner of this one's gonna be through two rounds. There were three knockdowns in the first round. Cervania scoring the first one and now coming in and landing a beautiful right hand, sending back Tomiyama into the corner. Tomiyama then scored two knockdowns of his own in the first round, thereby, I'm sure, edging Cervania on the judges' scorecard. Cervania has been marked, cut on the right eye.
Step back, ready.
Referee is Danrek Kapsadan. I tell you, these have been meaty-like blows that both of these fighters have been landing in this fight. In his world championship effort, if you take a look at it, Tomiyama fought this very well early, but he really ran out of gas, and he was stopped in the eighth round.
Ready,
he just had nothing left in that round. So it will be interesting to watch to see how, if this fight goes a distance of ground, how he reacts in the later rounds. Cervania has had good stamina in his fights. He's been the 10 and 12 round distances on a number of occasions. Very nice combination by Tomiyama, and Cervania answers right back, but Tomiyama's was the more effective. Now Cervania with the left hook. But he never stopped bouncing.
Rich, how long he can keep up that pace. I mean, like you said, he's constantly bouncing his arms, constantly moving.
It's difficult. It seems to me to be a lot of wasted energy, but that's... Ooh.
Hard right, and down goes Tomiyama for the second time. Fourth knockdown of the fight, and that was the worst one yet. He was really flattened, but he got up, and he seems okay. He seems to have his legs underneath him. And let's see what Cervania can do. By Cervania. Tomiyama in trouble. Backed into a corner. Bell sounds. End of the round.
I don't know if he knows it's the end of the round.
But he needed it.
Very much so.
Over here
with okay. Don't worry.
Miguel Diaz going to work on that cut, and Cervantes, as we take a look at the knockdown, a left hand and then the right hand over the outstretched left of Tomiyama. Well done. There's that right hand. I mean, a crushing right. We have had four knockdowns so far. This is the fourth of the fight, and each man has visited the canvas twice. Fans definitely getting their money here at the Cotai Arena. As we start round four of this WBO Asia Pacific Super Bantamweight Championship. I do think, as I'm looking at Tomiyama, that he looks still a little bit rocky. That knockdown coming right near the end of the round. But he's trying to get his jab going and try to get a rhythm once again. He was successful in the first round of being able to get himself, gather himself, and get himself back into the fight by utilizing that jab. And before the round was over, he had scored two knockdowns. Now he goes back to that formula here again. But Cervantes is undeterred and comes forward with that strong left. I tell you, Genesis, when he throws that left hook, really has a good leverage on it. And now you see what I mean. You know, it's almost hard to believe, as you take a look at Cervantes, that he has only scored seven KOs in his 20 victories. Some fighters learn to punch better, learn how to sit down on their punches, learn to get proper leverage in their punches as they go along and develop. And now Tomiyama mounting his own comeback and getting a little bit encouraged. The crowd sensing that as well, urging him on. I get the feeling there's really no crowd favorite here in this fight. They're rooting for both guys, pulling for both men. They've just been enjoying what has been an intense action between these two. Tomiyama does have the good jab, but he is susceptible to the left hook from long range by Cervantes. Nice combination. That's a good 1-2 that Tomiyama has. Now he comes forward. He pushes Cervantes up against the ropes, and here comes Genesis back. Cervantes is known as a guy who throws a high volume of punches. And the one thing I like about him and in seeing him is that he has a wide variety of punches. He mixes up his attack. Good arsenal.
Ready.
But he has been shown that he can be hit and hurt here tonight. And dropped. As he has been on two occasions.
Step back.
Tommy, if Gama decides it's a good time to hold on here, now let just under half a minute to go in round number four. Corner where he drops on the stool.
What a battle. The crowd that got here early, which is a good amount, Rich, if you kind of look around, a good amount only in the second fight here.
Well, that's what I like to see. This fight, the fans arriving very early and seeing these deep undercard fights, and they're getting rewarded with a tremendous fight. At the end of the round, it was Cervantes scoring that left hand to the head that really had Tomiyama in a bad way. Look at him. He has that blank look on his face as he goes back to his corner. There's Miguel Diaz, the famed Miguel Diaz. One of the best in the business, longtime veteran, working on that cut in the corner. This fight very much up for grabs. We begin round five. It is scheduled for 10. It's a super bantamweight battle. Each man has been down twice. Cervantes suffering from what is a tough cut. They have had a tough time stemming the blood. And Adesanya loading up. Very enjoyable bout. So you come out here to Macau and you visit this magnificent hotel, the Venetian Hotel. And terrific arena here where Manny Pacquiao will fight November 23rd against Brandon Rios. You'll see this big future here in Macau. Hope you're enjoying it. And in the United States, of course, fans getting up early to see this one. And they too are being rewarded, like the fans in the stands. Boy, Cerrone tried to load up with his right. Usually he starts off those exchanges with his good left hooks. That time tried to lead right. Tomiyama also has a very good right, but usually it follows his jab. Good counter left by Cerrone.
He really comes on the second half of these rounds. Cerrone does.
And I tell you, he's throwing just punches that are like bricks.
Absolutely.
Digging that right hand underneath. Still up in his toes, though. And, you know, it's hard to generate power when you're doing that, all of that jumping. But he is certainly, in his last few fights, he has been generating power, and he's certainly generated it tonight against a quality opponent. Remember, as we mentioned, Tomiyama has fought for a world title, 23-5-1 in his career. Title he fought for was at 115, so this is a much bigger weight for him here at Super Bantam.
Step back. Let me have ready. Box.
This arena, by the way, inside they have six videos boards for the fans to, I mean, you're going to be close up to the action. Long range right hand, and again, right at the end of the round, Tomiyama finds himself in a little trouble. And he is beginning, as I see him walk back to his corner, to get a bit of a jaded look on his face, and I believe to be wearing down now. Sits down hard on the stool. Across the ring here, looking at Miguel Diaz going to work on both eyes. And there are no shortage of ring card girls or dancing girls in the arena. And I even saw the Zhu Ximing dancers yesterday in the lobby of the hotel going through a routine just out of nowhere. They came into the lobby, music came on, and the next thing you knew, they were doing a dance.
They're in the business of entertaining here, the Venetian Macau.
Box.
Here we go into round number six. Cerrone seems to be gaining control, I believe, of the fight at this point. Scheduled for 10. And they set a torrid pace through the first five rounds. Rich Murata ringside at the Cotai Arena. Very happy to be joined by Christina Poncher here at our ringside table. I want to give a shout out to the great Colonel Bob Sheridan, who, as you see so many times, of course, internationally and on these top-ranked broadcasts, international broadcasts throughout the world for so many years. And the Colonel recently had heart surgery, but he's already bounced back. He is home. He is wisecracking and joking. I got an email from him today that he was typical jokes in there. And it was great to hear from him, and we wish him all the best. Glad he's recovering very well. He'll be back at the mic very soon. Nice combination by Tomiyama as he tries to regain some momentum. He even dug a right hand to the body. Tomiyama's been mostly a headhunter through the fight.
Rich, I've noticed Tomiyama shaking his right hand a lot, just throwing that jab out with the left, but not really throwing the right with much force. I don't know if it's causing him a little bit of trouble, but he's been kind of shaking it, letting it loose, and as you can see, just not really throwing that right
hand. Maybe that's when he threw it hard, he threw it to the body of Servanian. Servanian really has a nice there. Once again, he a good pickup there. Christina Heap was waving that right arm. Let's see if he shows it any more to the head. He threw that one hard right that he's thrown in this round was to the body of Servanian. A one-armed fighter against Servanian is going to be in some real trouble. Now Tomiyama comes over the top, and I see a smear of blood on Tomiyama's face as well. I think coming from the nose as he tries to flash out his jab. And as you can see, that they're doing better with the cut now on Servanya. It's not bleeding as much as it was midway through the round. With a hard right, Tomiyama in some trouble, staggers back a second, started to teeter a little bit. Glances over at his corner. Right back to the jab goes Tomiyama. We've got another terrific bout coming up after this one. You don't want to go anywhere. Rex So against Rusalie Samore. Little counter right by Tomiyama, at least showing it there as we come to the end of the round. Konosuke looking a little worried in his corner, and there's the reason why. He's getting nailed with those right hands. His eyes were wide open, though, and they seemed clear in the corner, but as you can see, right at this point, he was in a little bit of trouble. Both fighters have been bloodied.
Not a very active round for Tomiyama that past round.
No, he seemed to be fighting actually through a fog a little bit in that last minute.
Definitely.
But as they start the round, he comes right out jabbing. I think that's a good idea for him. He needs to establish himself, get his legs back underneath him, and try to get his rhythm once again. And the best time to do that and the best way to do that is to go right back to fundamentals. And for Tomiyama, that means going back to his jab and trying to set things up once again. Dennis Servanya, you may have doubted, can bounce for 12 rounds or 10 rounds, is still bouncing here in round number 7. Been a good mix of styles between these two. It's been high action and hot action between them. 4 knockdowns, as we mentioned earlier. The two fighters were both down in the first round. Tomiyama scored 2 knockdowns. Servanya scored 2 knockdowns. Tanya really digging that left. I think if he was not up on his toes so much, he really would generate a little more power than he has throughout his career. But he's shown that he does have a power. He's not devoid of power despite that low knockout ratio. Of course, tonight in the main event, in a very good card here that also has heavyweights, Andy Ruiz against Joe Hanks on it. Later on, Zhou Ximing, the Chinese gold medal winner, 2-time gold medal winner, actually, will be making his second professional start. That fight will be aired. For those of you in America, you can watch that fight tonight on HBO2. It's nice to see the broadcast crew of Larry Merchant, Tim Ryan, George Foreman yesterday. George holding court at the press conference for Pacquiao and Rios today. It was very funny, as usual. Allen not having a bad round here. Actually, he's having a pretty good bounce back round. He seems to have found a little bit of a rhythm. Now Cervania himself trying to utilize a jab. I would guess that Cervania is ahead on points at this juncture, but Tomiyama showing he can still summon up some strength and energy, but there's that good left hook. I love the left hook that Cervania throws. He can really dig it to the body, too, body or hand. Nice jab work, though, by Tomiyama. Comes up with an uppercut there.
Time!
End of round seven. Oh, what an enervating fight. They're late getting the stool into the ring from Tomiyama. Now they do. As we take a look at the action, the Cervania from long range doing real work there. Tomiyama taking a moment off, but still able to counter with the left hand. Tomiyama looking a little discouraged in the corner. Round eight, scheduled for 10, WBO Asia Pacific Super Bantamweight title on the line. Now there is one that you may not have heard of in the United States, for those of you watching in the U.S., but it means a lot here, because we are very much in Asia. We have a Japanese fighter against a Philippine fighter here. We'll have a Thai fighter against a Chinese fighter in our next fight. Good right hand by Tomiyama. Well, I tell you, I thought at the end of round six that Tomiyama had just about had the course. He answered on a nice bounce back round on that seventh, utilizing the jab. Getting some rhythm going. It would appear to me that the harder puncher at this point is Cervania. Tomiyama's having good fortune with his boxing ability. Best for him to keep the fight at long range. Cervania gets within punching range. It's good for him with that left hook. Left hook to the bodies especially. Tomiyama not
ready.
Playing to the crowd now.
Ready. Box.
Cervania turned pro in 2009. He had seven fights in his first year. Last year went through three fights. This is his second fight this year. His first one was against Anke Angoda. So he's fought good competition himself. We mentioned Tomiyama had fought for a world title, but Cervania, his last fight against Anke Angoda, and he stopped him in seven rounds. And Angoda is a guy who we've seen in the ring go the distance with Jorge Arce. We've seen him fight to Fernando Montiel, so he's been in there with good, very good fighters recently, really picking up his level of competition. And this is another tough opponent here for him.
Step back. Konosuke. Ready.
I'm not exactly sure what Tomiyama was looking at, except maybe one of the mini video boards, because he was staring up into the skies, dropping his arms there, and again appearing a little bit tired as Tomiyama. And you can certainly understand why. This fight was fought at a ridiculously high energy pace in the first four rounds. Nice combination, and a follow-up right by Cervania, and another right, but was partially blocked by the shoulder of Tomiyama. Tomiyama answers back with a right of his own, and here they go again as the bell sounds to end round eight.
The end of these rounds, Rich.
Yes, the last 15 seconds of almost every round are scorchers.
You had earlier mentioned the fighters from different countries, and looking at the bout sheet here, seems to be about 8 different countries represented on tonight's card in the entirety. Pretty unique.
It's very unusual. I think, really, taking a look at this card, to have that many fighters from different countries, I don't think I've ever seen a professional card. And I've been calling a lot of fights for a lot of years that had this kind of international flavor in terms of having so many countries. You'd have to go to something like the Olympic Games to go to a fight card and see that many different countries represented.
I was counting and I'm like, here we go. Japan, Thailand, China, Mexico, USA, Russia, Philippines, Thailand. I mean, Japan. The World Games here.
Yes, it is. And there is a fighter, in fact, Evgeny Gradovich, who fights later on the HBO 2 card that you'll be able to see later on tonight, who is known as the Mexican Russian.
So, right. So if that counts as another one, we'll make that 9.
For two. That's his nickname. He fights out of the Robert Garcia stable.
Quite a personality, huh? We had some fun in the fighter meetings with him.
Yeah, he's a very clever kid. We are in round 9. I think probably both fighters are happy this one wasn't scheduled for 12. Because they have given it their all.
Ready.
6 minutes remaining. I believe Cervantes ahead on the cards, I would think, to this point. But Tomiyama's been very much in this fight. He has great moments, it seems, every round. Scored 2 knockdowns of Cervantes in the first round.
Did you think this was going the distance after how it started, Rich?
It certainly did not. And it may still not.
It may still not. We still have time.
Tomiyama having success with the right hand, first to the head, then to the body, and shoves an elbow into the face. He wants to get right at his foe, and he's coming right at Cervantes. And as you can see, Tomiyama's encouraged by the success he's had.
Go there.
Another cut for Savanya.
And it's immediately called by referee Danrex Topsadon as a headbutt. This fight may be over. It is. This fight is over. Now, Tomiyama thinks he has won, and I do not believe that he has won. The referee, Tomiyama, thinks that he has scored a TKO victory. That is not the case. That is not the case. They are calling a headbutt. Do not be misled by that celebration of Tomiyama. There you see the terrible cut that was just open, and they're calling it a headbutt, which means they are going to score the fight and score that last round. The referee is collecting the scorecards. Fight was stopped by the doctor in the corner. And that was an immediate decision, by the way, to stop the fight at that point. There was no hesitation on the part of the doctor informing the referee this has to stop right here. Tomiyama is going up to each of the ring card girls and hugging each one of them. Now, unless they have awarded the fight to Tomiyama, which I don't think they have, because the referee told the judges score the round. Settled down a little bit, so. We'll take a look at the end of the fight right now. comes in, and the referee looks at the cut, says time, waves Tomiyama to a neutral corner, and there you see him saying headbutt. Now watch this. Boy, the doctor said no right there.
They have to be going to the scorecards now, don't they?
That would be my interpretation, that the fight would have to be scored. Referee told the judges at the end of the round, score the round. I heard him clearly say, score the round.
Let's see what Lupe has to say.
So Lupe Contreras will give us the official verdict.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. After an accidental clash of heads, referee Tata-san stops the bout with an official time of 1 minute 42 seconds of the ninth round. And in accordance with the rules of the WBO, we go to the scorecards to determine a winner. Damas y caballeros, atención, por favor. El referee Tata-san para la contienda por causa de un choque de cabezas accidental. Y de acuerdo con las reglas de la OMB, consultamos a la tarjeta oficial para determinar un vencedor. The scorecard reads as follows. Judge Shimiyama scores the bout 87-82 in favor of Cervania. Judge Shimiyama scores the bout 87-82 a favor de Cervania. El juez Tawikun 85-84 a favor de Tomiyama. Judge Tawi Dune scores the bout 85-84 in favor of Tomiyama. And Judge Lagumbay scores it 86-83. El juez Lagumbay anotó 86-83 a favor del ganador por decisión dividida técnica in favor of the winner by way of technical split decision. And still, WBO Asia Pacific champion, y aún campeón peso super gallo Asia Pacífico de la OMB, Genesis Cervania.
Well, there it is, just a tremendous battle between these two. Hope you fans enjoyed it. Everybody here did. There you see the first knockdown, a terrific left hook scored by Cervania in the first round. Tomiyama came back, scored a knockdown, actually with a left jab moments later. Then Tomiyama really came on and scored a very legitimate knockdown there with the overhand right. He was cut in the second round. Referee looked at it, said it's okay, and then he scored a fantastic knockdown in round number three that you can see Tomiyama needed some time to recover from. And from then on, it was just hammer and tong back and forth, the two of them, each at moments having moments of control. And in round number eight, it was Tomiyama coming on, backing Cervania up. Then, in the ninth of the cut from the headbutt, referee and the doctor conferred. It was immediately stopped at that point. They went to the scorecards, split decision. Genesis Cervania, winner and still champion on a technical split decision.
Ocho de sus victorias por la vía del knockout. He steps in undefeated in 21 professional bouts. Eight of those victories coming by way of knockout. El actual campeón peso super gallo Asia Pacífico de la OMB. He is the defending WBO Asia Pacific Super Bantamweight Champion from Bacolod City, the Philippines. Genesis Cervania.
Genesis, come on. Okay. Give me a good clean fight. 10 rounds WBO Asia Pacific Championship. Protect yourself at all times. Touch gloves. Good luck. So Wayne, ready?
Okay. La esquina azul, vestido de negro con vivos color rosa. Detuvo la báscula a un peso oficial de 122 libras. He tipped the scales at an official 122 pounds. As a professional, he maintains a record consisting of 23 victories against 5 losses, 1 draw, and 8 of those victories coming by way of knockout. A nivel profesional, mantiene un récord de 23 victorias con 5 derrotas, 1 empate y 8 de sus victorias por la vía del cloroformo. Fighting out of Tokyo, Japan, Konosuke Tomiyama. In the red corner, en la esquina roja, vestido de color blanco con vivos negros, he steps in wearing white with black trim. His official weight, 121.6 pounds. Su peso oficial, 121.6 libras. A nivel profesional, se mantiene invicto con 21 victorias.
Not a big KO mark, but as you can see, he is not devoid of power, and he lands a good left hook there. And a very rocky start for Tomiyama. Sagrania looking great here in the opening moments, and now Tomiyama comes back with his first combination of the fight. And here comes Sagrania, and these two are throwing the leather early. Tomiyama is trying to get himself into the fight now. A little bit different after that very rocky first minute. And he scores a knockdown with a left hand. Both fighters have tasted the canvas here in round one. Mandatory eight count for the champion, Zerbania. Here comes Tomiyama back. And now we are getting the fight we expected. Good jab by Tomiyama. Konosuke with a very good comeback.
Box.
Welcome back to Macau. Second of our bouts on TopRank.com. We're seeing it live around the world, and this is one we've been looking forward to. Super Bantamweight battle. Genesis Cervania is the defending WBO Asia Pacific Super Bantamweight Champion against Konosuke Tomiyama, a long-rangey fighter in Tokyo, Japan, and he is down quickly. A sudden and dramatic turn that this fight takes immediately. Taking the mandatory eight count. Just about to tell you that Tomiyama has actually fought for the world championship a couple of years back against Nobuo Nishiya and had him down in the first round, but it is he who goes down in the first round of this bout. Cervania, very quick start. Cervania's nickname Bazooka comes into the ring with a record of 20-0, only 7 KOs.
Ladies and gentlemen, we continue with the action here at Cotai Arena, once again proudly being brought to you by Bob Arum's Top Rank Incorporated. This bout in association with Ala Boxing Promotions. Tecate con Carácter, Anta, Foreman Boys Promotions, and our host, the Venetian Macau. This bout set for a limit of 10 rounds for the WBO Asia Pacific Super Bantamweight Championship. Damas caballeros, este duelo pactado un límite de 10 vueltas por el título peso Super Gallo Asia Pacífico de la OMB. Supervisor, supervisor, Leon Panoncillo. The judges are, los jueces son, Sawa Eng Tawikun, Salvin Lagumbay, and Takeshi Shimakawa. The referee, Danrex Tapdasan. Introducing the blue corner. He steps in wearing black with pink trim, presentando